Greetings, family. Welcome to my channel. Thank you so much for connecting. You are most welcome. Wonderful people of the Most High God, there is one thing to have in mind. Every time you wake up in the morning, there is a decision for you to make. You decide how you are going to live that day. You can choose to live in faith, expecting to be happy, expecting the favor of God to manifest in your life that day, or you can choose to be discouraged, defeated, or focused on problems that are happening around you. I want you to understand that happiness does not just happen automatically. You have to make a choice. You can't wait to see what kind of day is going to be. You can't wait to wait for the day to happen to you. You must happen to that particular day on that particular day in which you wake up. Hear me, people of the Most High God. The first thing in the morning, you have to make a decision. I'm going to live this day happy. I am going to live this day gratefully. I'm going to love my family. I'm going to enjoy this day. I'm not going to allow anyone to mess up with my day. If you allow circumstances or people to decide for you, that is how your day is just going to turn out into another way or into another direction. You'll see all problems and think, I don't feel like going to work. If you allow circumstances to decide for you, you know, you will think of traffic and just feel, I'm just in the mood, not in the mood to be going through that. You know, when you dwell on your thoughts, you choose to be discouraged. But then if you choose to be happy, you override all the negativity and you see the good in that particular day. The scripture says that joy comes in the morning. That's Psalm chapter 30, verse 5. Every morning, God sends a new supply of joy. Every morning, God sends a fresh supply of joy. You can dismiss it by not choosing right, or you can accept it by making the correct choices of living in happiness. People of God, this, you can just say, oh, this is not for me. It's just too much. I just can't take it anymore. That's the choice and that's the mood you have taken for that day. Or you can receive it and say, things may not be perfect in my life, but God is on the throne, and I know all things work together for good for those who love him, and I'm going to enjoy my day. This is what David said, that all kinds of opposition coming up against his life, but he still said, I am going to make it. Though they were slandering him, though there were family problems, but in the middle of it all, he said, this is the day that the Lord has made. I will rejoice and be glad in it. This is the day. This is the day that the Lord has made. Psalm 118, verse 24. So you can decide to do that. If he was reporting on his circumstances, he would have said, the Lord has made this day, but I've got a lot of problems. Instead, David was making a declaration of faith despite the opposition. He said, I will be happy. Despite people lying against him, he said, I will be happy. Despite maybe his family not believing in him, he said, I am going to leave this day happy. So people of the Most High God, if you are going to be happy, you have to be happy on purpose, because there will be betrayals, there will be delays in life, there will be all kinds of things that will cause you to live your life sour, without any joy, without any smile. But you have to put your foot down and say, that's it. I'm not letting the circumstances to rule my day. I'm not letting circumstances to steal my joy, but I'm going to be happy. All things are working for my good, and I'm going to rejoice. Know your will is more powerful than how you feel. You have to decide first. You have to decide first. Then happiness will come next. You control your happiness. It's not up to anyone else, but you can be as happy as you want to be. despite all things that are going on around you. So thank you so much for connecting. May you have a happy and a blessed day. This is the Lord that is, you know, at work in your life. This is the Lord that has created this day. This is the Lord that has given you that joy. Make use of it, take it, and rejoice in that day. May God bless you, and shalom to you all. If you have not liked, commented, subscribed, make sure you do so, and I will respond to your comments down there below. May God bless you, and shalom.